Here's a green block down here at the bottom. Okay. We may have got it. We got 5 minutes, so that's okay. We're okay. Category education. Toddle. Excellent connection. Steve has got off his phone. Okay. Edit. Exit stream. The stream can be accessed again from the managed list, exiting or not in the stream if it is currently. Should I go here to edit?
How are we doing? Very well. You gonna get to see the kids for the holidays and everything?
Here's a visibility private.
We're going to have a big feed Saturday. Diane's mother, 92-year-old,
where's It says public.
We got this weekend planned out.
Sounds like the grandkids don't have any choice but to get spoiled.
If they don't get spoiled, it's just
magic. You have a right shame.
Can you grab
it?
Yeah,
right shame.
Yourself? Are you going that way?
We are. We'll be there, I guess, tomorrow night. Well, and then Elizabeth's going to go spend time with her dad.
This
will be
the recording is
time
up.
They're both in Oklahoma. There's different parts. Different parts of the state.
At 6:28.
So I need to be in Branson for the first part.
Did you do it?
Anyway, yeah, the kids and folks will be coming in Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. So we'll have our big feed on Friday. I have 3 kids. Yes. They're scattered over. So we're scattered. We're in Arkansas. Have a son
so,
in Missouri,
but it's
a
going,
son
right?
in Kansas,
we're
and a daughter in Oklahoma. So we're so.
Okay, it's
our central.
This camera.
She said, "Well, this is, becomes our anchor."
So anything I said back here in the booth is covered.
So that's nice. Okay. Bates. Is that where she is?
Okay.
Okay.
So, yes, sir. No problem.
They'll do Thanksgiving.
They'll say something. Unless I say something, it's all
set. There you go.
So, all right.
We have one. So,
how
old? He is 4 months.
Oh, 4 months. Oh, look at that.
He'll be 5 months next week. Oh, my 22nd. That's all right. He lives in Missouri.
Okay.
So they live in the Republic, outside of Springfield.
Okay.
Yeah, my son works for Liberty Electric. He's a lineman for them, and our daughter in law is a nurse there at Cox. Well, hey, y'all have safe travels.
Appreciate y'all soon.
Yep.
Is it true? Can I put it right down the back?
Two, three. I love you, Steve.
Sorry. Would it bother you if I put these two items right here?
No. Just make sure the lid's on the thing. If not, it's Steve. What are you saying this game? That he's going to give me a stroke?
No, it wasn't. No, it wasn't.
I hate you.
They can hear everything that's on.
Is that what you put in everybody's phone? What's your real name?
I don't know why.
What? I'm special.
That's not a nickname.
Your name is okay. Good evening and thank you for coming to tonight's performance. My name is Chris Thompson and I teach in the music department here at Williams. And on behalf of the music department, I'd like to welcome you to tonight's concert. Sponsoring tonight's program is the Schubert Music Club, which was founded in 1928, not too far off of our 100th anniversary. Speaking of 100 years, the club recently had the honor, this last weekend, in fact, of celebrating the 100th birthday of our oldest living member, Mrs. Catherine Ponder, and I'm not sure if she's here this evening, but we're very proud of her. Very briefly, when Mrs. Massey came to WBU in the fall of 2018, I asked him if he would be willing to do a program for our music club, and he kindly agreed. I thought he might say no, he was so busy. But he graciously agreed, and I think all but last year we had programs due to COVID we didn't last fall. Well, you're in for a real treat tonight. Mr. Massey and the band put together a fine program of Christmas music, a number of his own compositions, and even a march. It's a band concert without a march, so a good march in tonight's program. Before the program begins, I'd just like to ask you to please silence your phones. So there won't be a distraction to the musicians on stage. So thank you again for coming tonight and enjoy the program.
Thank you.
I don't see me make it up and down these steps several times. The first song was called Scriptura. It's a brand new piece written to commemorate actually the 100th anniversary of Amaral Music Stores that serves us at Memphis. They've been around a long time and are wonderful to music educators. In fact, they loaned us every semester the instruments we need for our music education majors to learn on. So we've been letting us do that, and then they sell them as used instruments. We're also going to sponsor an event called Amaral University in April, and it's for music education majors from all over the Mid-South that they sponsor, and it's going to be a great opportunity for us. So I hope you like that. This one is the one that we're all kind of excited about. This is a very, very complex work. It's based on the fact that music was an integral part of Native American life. Some liberty has been taken, but mostly it's the actual tunes from different tribes. You're going to hear four sections: the butterfly dance from New Mexico's Pueblo tribe symbolizes elusiveness and the ability to escape danger. The gar song is from Oklahoma's Creek Nation, and it symbolizes the importance of wildlife. The stomp dance is from Oklahoma's Cherokee Nation and is ritual dancers and singers performing around a sacred fire to worship the Creator. And then the alligator dance is from the New York Iroquois and it's performed indoors simply for entertainment. The composition is based on the research of Dr. Charlotte Heff, who's the director of Native American Indian Studies at the Smithsonian Institution, and her recording served as the impetus for this work. We really think you're going to enjoy this unusual Songs of Earth, Water, Fire, and Sky by Robert Livingston.
Thank you.
And if you were a soloist during that moment, would you please stand? move into the Christmas season now. It's time, Walmart says so. We're going to do a piece that you can see in the program. It's called Angels of Joy, and it's a high energy mix up of three angel pieces, angels in the title. Harp, herald, angels, sing, angels we have heard on high, and joy of the world. The composer is really creatively intertwined all the melodies, and we are happy to kick off the Mount Walmart official Christmas season with you this evening. This next piece is a little bit on the quirky side. I discovered it when actually researching music for a different occasion altogether. It was written by Arthur Pryor in 1898 for his very famous, at the time, Pryor's traveling band. It was on the bar with the Sousa Band, the Fillmore Band, and Bouncer Band was pop music of its age. It was inspired by the tales of folks in the South who get together after the harvest and start husking the corn and putting away the peas and taking care of everything, get ready for winter. And so he wrote some kind of original folk tunes to go with it, and I think it turned out to be a really interesting piece, and it's definitely different. It's definitely a change of pace than what most people are used to hearing. Feel free to tap your toes, but don't clap when necessary. Irish roots are influenced in this composition, and you'll hear a lot of with some phonic variations on the hymn tune. You'll hear a fanfare, you'll hear a quiet Celtic flute section before you finally hear the hymn. There are sudden tempo changes, there are shifting tonalities, and it builds right at the end to a climactic finish where half the band is going one speed and one time signature, and the other guys are going a different speed and another time signature, and then closes with the return to the original fanfare. We like this one a lot, we hope you will too. This is Speed Out My Vision.
Thank you.
until just now, I didn't realize it was a Shelby Haynes show. And that's all for himself. Well, we got one more in the Christmas spirit for you, and it's Richard Salcedo's pretty inventive composer, contemporary composer. And he just decided, I don't know if he was just having a day where he felt being silly, but he takes the Deck of Halls melody and just twists it around and plays with it, and it's really kind of neat. The result is a lot going on, and it's written just to enjoy playing, as long as you're not trying to sing along. This is a Fantasy on Deck of Halls. Thank you all so very much. Before we go on, we have two students who are going to graduate next month. And apparently they're not willing to quit their jobs to come back to rehearse. So we're going to have to say goodbye to them. Both of these young adults were in the original group 4 years ago. And if some of you were around that, it was a tiny little group that played its heart out. So they're part of what we call the charter members of the entire organization. And they both have been incredible leaders and musicians and cheerleaders of whatever needed to happen to help the band along. And we are certainly going to miss them and their contributions. So I'd like you to recognize, please, Caleb, Harris, and Lauren. Written by my favorite march composer, Henry Fillmore. It was written in 1939 for the Baltimore's most popular marchers. Thank you for coming out and supporting what we're doing. There are so many great things happening at Williams, so many new programs, so many old programs that are outstanding. It's just an incredible place to be day in and day out, and we've been incredibly blessed with all of the things that we're allowed to do. So we appreciate you being here and supporting that. We're becoming more and more well-known. We have, I don't want to miss it, 74 applications for the fall, and 3 commits. So we want you to have a blessed and safe Thanksgiving break, and then have a Merry Christmas when you decide to Christmas season. Thank you so much. Thank you.